Ho 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 everyone, I'm excellent gift giver and staunch Kringleist Dan Umpthen. It's notoriously difficult getting gifts for other people, but maybe I can make that a little easier for the nerd in your life. Nerds are really easy marks. If there's anything that comic fandom is about, it's about having stuff. Just stuff, whatever kind of stuff. Lots and lots of stuff. But if you're trying to find a non-comic gift, something that's non-nerdy for some of the friends in your life, look at what character they like and make an extrapolation based off of that. If they're into Batman, get them a set of dumbbells. If they don't want to use them, they're not really that into Batman, are they? Retail price $40. Iron Man or Cyborg fans? Get them an iWatch or something like that. That's like $399. For Thor fans, a sledgehammer. Retails for $24.99. For Deadpool fans, get them a chain wallet and a corn CD at Goodwill. Retail price, $3. I have not been nice to Deadpool fans in this dumb thing. If they're a big Doctor Who fan, get them a life. Retail price, that series has gone downhill since Russell T. Davies left the show. If they're a Hulk fan, get them anger management classes. If they're into Miss Marvel, get them yoga classes for stretching. If they're a Green Lantern fan, get them a copy of Friedrich Nietzsche's Die Weltzeremacht. It's $13 on Amazon. If they like Doctor Strange, get them a copy of the Necronomicon. Retails for the cost of your sanity at the Miskatonic bookstore. Seriously though, you can't go wrong with a t-shirt or trade paperback of their favorite character. There's a lot of essential books that maybe whoever it is you're shopping for hasn't read. You can't go wrong with a trade by Brian K. Vaughan or Grant Morrison, John Hickman, Alan Moore, any of the classic comic authors, Neil Gaiman. There's plenty of them out there. But if you're looking for something current that they maybe have missed, that's definitely worth reading, that they'll always appreciate, trade paperback of The Wicked and the Divine, Monstress, Saga, Phonogram, Manhattan Projects, just to name a few. Those are good starting places. I can almost guarantee you that they're not picking up all of those, but they're definitely worth checking out. While we're talking about characters, there's absolutely no nerds that are too old for a Lego set or an action figure of their favorite character. Absolutely nobody's going to hate it, and no matter what they say, they're going to remember it and love you to death for it. If you want to go big for a surefire gift, tickets to a Comic-Con are always a good idea. San Diego's coming up. Tickets for C2E2 are available right now. There's a lot more that are in range in the Midwest. But that's definitely expensive. If you want to go lower cost, a coffee gift card, especially from Capes, is not going to hurt at all. Even if people don't drink coffee, guaranteed they can find something at most coffee shops, but especially at Capes. They've got a lot of smoothies, hot chocolates, stuff like that, that it's perfect. Contrary to popular belief, I think most people are fine with gift cards, even from somebody that they know intimately. They're not going to be upset by it. It's not your job to know the ins and outs of every single part of their fandom or what they like, and if you can get them a gift card or even a preloaded Visa or something like that for whatever they actually want, nobody's going to turn their nose up at it, unless they're a jerk. But if you go to their comic book shop and you buy them a gift card for, say, $25, $50, I guarantee you they'll appreciate that. Anyway, there is another chance for you to do something very good and give a great gift this year. The Doomcast and Capes Cafe are going to set up a clothing drive at Capes location through Hope Ministries. Not through them, we're going to be donating clothes to Hope Ministries, which has done a lot of provable good for people in the Des Moines area. Specifically, they need men's clothes, men's razors, and deodorant, new or packaged underwear or socks that could definitely be used. Although any kind of clothing is welcome. Hope Ministries is religiously affiliated, and while some of you may object to religious affiliation, you can't argue or object with the provable good that they have done in the Des Moines area over and over again, and the only way they're able to do that is with donations. And so I think it's something that's worth doing, and I'd like your help in doing so. They treat homelessness the way it should be treated, which is as a social problem and not a disease or something that's to be stigmatized or something that's criminal. They treat people who are homeless as that. People. So if you get it in your head to make a donation, or you're just stopping into Capes to grab gifts for somebody that you love that's really nerdy in your life, stop in and do it. Thank you very much. We'll see you next week.